Hey, sports fans, Coach Nick here, and welcome to B-Ball Breakdown. Let's break right into it on D'Angelo Russell's finest game as a rookie. Coming at home against the hapless Nets, deloading filled the stat sheet up with an efficient shooting night as the Lakers embarked on installing a new offense with only 22 games left in the season. It didn't get in the way last night, so let's find out how Russell detonated. D'Angelo gets on the board with a simple high spread pick and roll after Clarkson cut off the Hibbert screen. The quick two-footed floater catches Brook Lopez late getting his hand up, and the ball drops softly through the net. This set didn't start out as smooth as possible, as Randall wanted Brown to bump down to the corner, but they find Randall in the ISO post-up. Stagnant offense with poor weak side spacing, and it leaves Russell with 5 seconds left on the shot clock to create against the set defense. Another good omen as his tough contested step back three barely touches the net. Again, more confusion as Nick Young is wandering, Russell wants him to cut up to the wing, and Larry Nance seems to want Lou to cut somewhere as well. This leaves Russell with the ball in the post, stagnant offense, and he uncorks a funky Dirk leg fadeaway. I think we all envisioned these types of plays when Russell was drafted. Grab the rebound, push the ball up on the dribble, then find a seam when the defense doesn't pick him up like it should. Nice little drifting floater with touch. More confusion as Brown is directing Bass, then Nance directs Brown, before finally breaking into a very simple high screen and roll. Russell tries to get his defender in jail, but instead opts for the Rondo behind the back fake, baseball bounce pass. But here's the key, when you drive and dish, the quicker you sprint back to the three-point line, the more likely you'll get an open jumper. Watch how he uses the hop to quickly get into alignment on his jumper. Gorgeous. If Nick Young is bringing the ball up, the likelihood of breaking into anything structured goes way down. It's weird spacing and formation, but credit Nance for the nice bounce pass. I wouldn't recommend splaying the legs out like this, but it's clear Russell ate his Wheaties this morning. I like this out-of-bounds play. Remember, if you want to get a shooter open, have him set an off-ball screen first, preferably a back screen. Bogdanovich actually screens his own teammate, getting Russell another clean look from three. Here's an attempt to run the Spurs motion weak. Russell should simply sprint to the right wing, but instead gets it along the lane line extended. We're supposed to get flex action happening a lot quicker than this, but they're still getting used to it, I suppose. As the play breaks down into freelance, Clarkson aggressively attacks the nail, Donald Sloan foolishly helps one pass away, and Russell smartly cuts into the vacuum. Gorgeous pass by Clarkson for the layup. After the turnover, Clarkson does all the work while Russell jogs to the three-point line. Look at his turn as he aligns his left hip and elbow to the basket before splashing another open three. Now that Russell is red hot, he's running to that line every chance he gets. And we certainly know Huertas ain't gonna shoot it as he finds him for another easy look from three. We've seen plenty of evidence of Russell's basketball IQ, and he's got a good feel for moving without the ball. The Lakers run high horns for Huertas, and Markel Brown gets caught ball watching. Easy pass, nice reverse. Trying to keep their fourth quarter lead, the Lakers make it exciting getting the ball in bounds before spreading the floor to let Russell go to work with another quick release floater before Lopez can get a hand on the shot. Clinging to a three-point lead, they ride the hot hand, but this alignment makes little sense. Setting a screen for Russell to go right, with Clarkson standing at half court and his man getting in the way. No matter, this is the Nets, and they defend this poorly. And Russell continues his red-hot game. Here's another Spurs staple called 25, where the two guards screen for the center before he ball screens. Russell does his Steph Curry imitation, pulling from 5 feet behind the line. No follow-through either. But he gets it off and that ball goes through clean and mean. And Russell puts aside a season's worth of frustration to let the world know that he's got ice in his veins. Well, at least when they play the Brooklyn Nets.